Ah, bom dia, faz favor de entrar. Vou estar aqui na sala com uma amiga.
I got you the little part in Girls on Top, and I started you off.
I know, but I haven't got any time.
Of course you've got time. You're always available.
I'm doing a television show.
And nobody watches your television shows, do they? It doesn't
really matter. Camera crew's here. Get out. Go out, and I'll be with you in a minute, okay? Just go outside.
Is that the crew from your show?
Yes, it is.
Don't... Come back.
Don't just go hide in the bathroom. Go out. Just go out, and I'll start the show outside. Get out.
Come here now.
Go out.
Here.
Hello, welcome to my show, where each week I open my front door and I let Mother Fate take me by the hand.
And this week Mother Fate will be taking you to Devon.
I meet people completely by accident.
Devon. Here we go to Devon.
Dawn, you're ruining the idea of the whole show. I don't do half variety shows like you do. I don't have gag lines and laugh tracks.
I
just go out the front door and I talk to anybody.
A photo of you with Muhammad.
I put my hand
Turkey
on the knob.
1987, remember?
Where?
Right here.
Give me that picture.
Here's the...
Give me that picture.
Doesn't matter what you do with it, Ruby. I've got copies and I'm going to make them into Christmas cards. Do you understand me?
Yes. Okay. Hello, I'll be going to Devon this week.
And I'll be opening a fete. I can't wait to meet all the rosy cheek people there.
And I can't wait to meet the cheeky cheek people that I'll be meeting there. You see, the problem is Dawn with her busy bee schedule. It's too busy and has dumped on everybody.
I would love to go to Devon today, but unfortunately I've got to go and pick up an award for being the funniest Jewish person in London.
Right, okay, then we're going now. We're going right now. We're going out the door.
Okay, there's a baby oil in this picture, I see.
Yes, I know.
Was the camel supposed to be doing
that? I'm going.
Okay, well, you'll need this dress then, won't you? I see Muhammad has no foreskin.
Right, so we're off to Devon. God, I hate that woman.
I know Dawn French.
Are you Dawn French?
No. You think I can get Dawn's autograph for you?
Yeah. You look stupid.
Graham. She's ill. She's a very ill person.
What
she's
do you
dying.
Mean?
She's in bed dying. Dawn French is dying in bed. I didn't bend down and pick it up. I legitimately caught the duck. Why would I lie about something like that?
I've seen you bend down and pick it up.
I bent down and picked it up and put a duck in a net? Are you insane? I caught this duck legitimately in the net.
No, you bent down and picked it up.
Look, I don't even want the duck. It's not worth 5p.
Right.
It's all Dawn French's fault. The nerve of that woman charging 5p for a lousy duck. A duck, for God's sake.
Excuse me, do you have a light?
No, I'm afraid I don't. I don't smoke.
Oh, it's so hot.
It's hot, isn't it? Yes.
What are you doing here?
I'm a gravedigger.
Right. So if Sony just pops off, they call you?
Well, not as easy as that. There's a bit more to it than that. I've got to wash them down, embalm them, and then put them in a coffin. And then when the funeral comes, I bring them over here and bury them.
Is this real normal work to you? I mean,
it is normal work for me, yeah.
Do any of them put up a fight? You know, when
one you're... One or two have, yeah. There's two, I've had a couple sat up on the bench.
No, when you're putting them into the grave?
Oh, no, not in there, in the mortuary, they sit up.
No.
Yeah, and they get air down the throat. And
a hair?
Yeah, and you sit up.
And go on.
Yeah, yeah.
And you have to pull the hair out?
No, it stays there. It's just air going back down the throat.
Oh, air?
Yeah.
I thought they swallowed a hair.
No, they've also got a hair in their throat.
Right.
But the air gets down beyond the hair and it pulls them forward.
And they just sit up like this?
Yeah.
And what do you do? Smoosh them down again?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
No.
Do you just get cool about this and this doesn't...
Oh, yeah, yeah. It only happened once or twice.
You just throw them down and keep setting their hair?
Yeah.
Do you do the expressions on their face, too?
Well, you can't really. They're frozen. You can't do nothing about that.
Where do you freeze them?
They're frozen in the fridge trays in the mortuary. We got big trays in the mortuary, which are...
Like cube trays?
Yeah, big fridges.
No.
Yeah.
Do you like your work, then?
Yes, I do, very much.
Really?
Yes.
What is it about it that's particularly appealing?
Well, it's been in the open air, meeting other people.
They might not be good conversation.
Well, not really, no.
No, I wouldn't think so.
I like it, it's quiet.
Wait, you talk at them.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
It's probably your only chance in life.
You get talking about drive you to it eventually.
Really?
Yeah.
It makes you crazy.
Well, no, not really. You gotta keep a level head about it, you know. I only do
Where
this.
Where do you live around here?
I live here. We're sitting on my bed.
This is your boudoir?
This is my bed, yeah.
How intimate.
And not often I have ladies on my bed.
Did you always live on here?
Yeah, yeah, basically. Apart from here, sometimes at the park, but mainly here, mostly.
How did this kind of thing start with you?
Well, I started basically because my friend said to me that we were arguing one day that we couldn't live without the system, being the modern system, living within it, like, you know.
Yeah.
And I proved to him you can, so I spent 2 weeks down on by the river in a tent, and it turned into months, then into years, and I spent nearly 11 years down there, winter and summer. I nearly died twice, but it was worth the effort to just prove a point, you know.
God, you're stubborn.
And I lived off the land. Hedgehog, crow, rook.
Crow?
Yeah.
Wait, crow?
Yeah.
Crow in what form?
In bird form, you know.
I know in bird form, but what, you saute the thing or fricassee? How do you eat the crow?
Oh, you pluck them and skin them, and then you cook them, grill them over a fire. And I make mine into a pie sometimes. I do a casserole, you know, with hedgehog.
It's a nice phyllo pastry.
Yeah.
What do you drink, a red wine or a white wine with those?
Nettle juice. They class me as an eccentric, you see.
Eccentric?
Yes.
And sort of the weirdo.
I sort of play up to it a bit, you know.
What, you wear a straw in your mouth?
When the grockles come.
What's a grockle?
A grockle's a holidaymaker, you know. When they come, they ask me, they talk to me, and I say I can't write, which I can. And I give them a thumbprint or a cross, you know.
Do they think you're really backwards?
Well, they can think what they want, you know. I am what I am, and that's it, you know.
I mean, do they consider you kind of like the town yokel?
Well, sort of thing, yeah. Yeah, they do, actually, yeah. They think I'm a bit of an oddball. But I've had a good education, but I don't want to use it. You know, I prefer it this way. And it has a bit of colour to life, doesn't it?
Better what?
Better colour, you know.
But are you happy like this?
I'm happy like this, Libby, yeah.
You're not lonely or anything?
No, not a bit, no. I've got the birds. Nature.
And the graves.
Yes.
And the open grave.
Yes.
I gotta get back to my freight.
Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, welcome to Sherwood Forest.
Your hand is on my behind.
Sorry.
Is that my cue?
And in it, he has held captive Maid Marian. And she, of course, is...
Just a minute. My dress is caught in the ladder. I'm caught in the ladder. Step.
And you can see that the sheriff
Thank
is there
you.
And he's trying to hold her back with his wicked henchmen, who incidentally are all wearing yellow hats. Well, now's the chance for Robin. Now, where's Robin? Look, there he is, Robin and his men. They're coming over now with, conveniently, a donkey.
Which one's Robin Hood?
The man wearing the boxer shorts.
I don't understand this. Excuse me, watch the sticks. Excuse me, you're on my dress again. It's on my dress. Somebody explain the sticks. This grown man with sticks. What? Are you the man with the boxer shorts?
Yes.
Gently. You're an idiot, you broke my nail! Ow, that really hurts. Don't squish it around like that. Ow. How do you turn this thing up? I have a really low pain threshold.
What happened then, Ruby?
Robin Hood fell on me. Amateur. I break my ankle for one line, and then I was upstaged by a mule. It's a nightmare. Please watch it, please. That really hurt. Don't twist
all right,
it around.
Ruby,
like
all
that.
Right, calm down.
I
can
know,
you move your toes for
no,
me?
No, I can't. I'm paralyzed.
Move your toes for me, please.
I'm paralyzed.
Ruby, please move your toes. Come on.
There. Ow. Is that working? Are they all right?
Yeah, they're all right.
It really hurts.
Where does it hurt most, Ruby?
All over.
Around your ankle?
It hurts all over.
All over.
Do you have any mascara?
I only use blue.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's see. Oh, you have really pretty eyes.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, you have greeny eyes.
No, they're blue.
Well, they're greeny, and that's...
No,
I
blue,
like that
really.
Bluey mascara. I don't use blue, I use black. Do you have any boyfriends?
I'm married.
Really? You
yeah.
look so young.
Thank you.
You really look young.
Thank you.
Who are you married to?
My husband.
Where'd you meet him?
In a pub. I used to work in a bar and I met him. He came in the pub one day and I thought I liked him.
You worked in a bar?
Yeah.
You didn't just go from working in a bar to this gig, did
no,
you?
No, no. I had three children in the meantime.
I mean, you were trained in everything.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So what happened? He came in the bar and did what?
He came in the bar and he was very shy. And I liked him. And I asked him out.
Yeah?
So, yeah, we went out. And then I asked him to marry me.
That's a wonderful story.
Yeah.
Why do I feel like Selah Black at this moment? Is that the only time you've been married?
No, I've been married before. I got married when I was 16 to a jockey.
A little man.
A little man, yeah.
How little?
5'2".
Oh, that's my size.
Oh.
That's teeny. You could have worn
small.
Him as a brooch. Good personality, or were we just going for facial things?
Just facial looks.
How shallow.
Very,
very thin.
I was only 16, maybe.
Oh, so young. I was in love with Mickey Mouse at 16. I can't imagine having to, you know, put out. Well, how naive were you?
Very, very.
So you saw this little jockey and thought I had to marry him?
Yeah.
Rather than put it on top of a cake?
Yeah. I wanted to wear a wedding dress.
Wow.
And that's the only reason why I married him.
So how long did it last?
2 months.
Just 2 months?
2 months.
But weren't you just shocked by, you know, because you're just like playing with little dollies at 16.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, how'd you cope with all the sex and stuff? What did you think?
That was taboo.
You didn't have sex with him?
No.
You were married and you didn't have sex?
No.
Well, what did you do? What did you do with your time?
I used to run away from him.
Oh, my God. I don't know what to say. But, I mean, you know, he was just tiny. You could have stepped on him, I guess, if an emergency came up. Could you turn that siren off? I can't hear myself talk. So what's it like in the ambulance biz?
Oh, it's very good. You get some weird and wonderful jobs.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
You know, some... Well, I remember one that springs to mind. It was a young man who got... We got a call from him. He was very upset. We didn't know why we had to go to see him. So we raced round there, and he was a breeder of Yorkshire Terriers.
Yeah.
And it wasn't just for breeding. They weren't just for breeding. And the dogs...
What were they for?
For his own use. Let's say his own use. And...
That he was doing something with the dog?
He was doing something with the dog.
I just have to lie here for a few minutes after that. No, that must have been the worst. I hope he's watching out there because we all say hello. What was his name?
No, I can't see his name.
Maybe we could get him on Surprise Surprise and reunite him with his, what was it, Yorkshire Terrier? People are wacky, aren't they?
There's absolutely nothing wrong with your foot, Ruby. It's fine.
Nothing wrong with it?
Nothing.
I'll be able to walk again?
Yeah, and it'd be a total waste of time going to London, to a hospital in London for this.
Well, then, driver, where are we?
Glastonbury.
Glastonbury. What do you know about Glastonbury?
Oh, it's the Glastonbury Festival here.
Oh, the festival.
Hmm.
Okay, driver, stop the ambulance. I'm getting off here.
There's a friend of mine there while you're there. Amanda Mercer. Will you say hi for me?
Amanda Mercer?
Amanda Mercer.
No, please give me that back.
No,
no,
I have
one
to
more,
have it
please.
Now.
We loved each other very much. Yeah. Just one
I'll
more
have
little.
It now. I'll have it now.
Please. Maybe I can buy this stuff in Glastonbury. Okay, driver! Stop the ambulance.
Are you going to this festival of joy and peace?
Give me a lift.
Where do I hold on? Anywhere? Everywhere? Does the word diet mean anything to you?
Oh, yeah, this is going to be easy. I have to find Amanda Mercer in this gaggle of humanoid. Why do I have to find her? It's the nature of the program. See, I meet one person and they lead me to the next. The domino theory. Don't ask. Anyway, I thought this festival was going to be a couple of hash heads sitting around a campfire singing Kumbaya. Excuse me. Instead, what do I get? 150,000 Looney Tunes and everybody looks the same. Excuse me. Excuse me. Are you Amanda Mercer?
Who?
Excuse me, do you know an Amanda Mercer?
Who, darling?
An Amanda Mercer.
A Mercer, that's an old-fashioned word for grocer, is that right? Why do you want to find one person out of how many thousand here? 50,000?
That's my problem.
Well, it's not a personal problem, it's a mathematical problem.
Excuse me, do you know somebody called Amanda Mercer? Hi, Krishna. Gesundheit.
Amanda Mercer.
You got something on your nose.
No, I do not know someone called Amanda.
That teaches.
No, it's not that Amanda. Do you know which Amanda I'm talking about?
No.
You don't
I'm
know?
I'm afraid not.
What are you doing here?
I'm living, celebrating life.
Did you make that line up?
No, I didn't.
You read it on the back of an album.
Amanda.
Yeah.
Well, that name, I think, has some connotation with, I don't know, Animal Aid, possibly, of 111 High Street or something in Tunbridge.
The thing is, you're probably looking for yourself more than you're looking for anyone else. You think you're looking for somebody else, because that's what's important to you right now.
I swear to God, I came here, it was definitely somebody who didn't look like me.
It's about time you sort of started looking for yourself instead.
But that'll throw my whole show off.
No, it won't. Your whole show is your life. Your whole show is you.
You know how you see your career going in front of your eyes?
Yeah.
That's what I'm experiencing.
I know, it's nice, isn't it?
Excuse me.
Hello?
Hello, do you have any toilet paper?
Oh, yeah, just a minute. Hang on, here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. What's your name?
Amanda.
Not Amanda Mercer.
Yeah?
I met a friend of yours.
You what?
Married to a jockey about an inch tall.
Where are you going now? Back to the teepee. You coming?
Yeah.
Okay, what about the paper? I'll have it back.
Look at how you live. It's just unbelievable. Who does the cleaning here? When was the last time this was Hoovered?
We've got cleaning ladies coming in here, you know.
You got maids? So when did we last wash our hair?
About 2 days ago.
Unbelievable. Something horrible has happened here.
Can you believe it?
Head and shoulders is my only word to you. But what do you do in real life?
We help each other to die.
You like that? Yeah, her tongue's coming out.
No, I was just stopped in
Amphibious.
My tracks.
We're traveling a path. A lot of what we do is we work in an old way with people. Yeah, we kill people in a certain way. We kill their negativity. We eat it.
And so what? So tell me practically. Like you lead workshops?
Yeah.
And what? 30 people come?
30 or more, yeah, or maybe less, 15, maybe, it doesn't matter. Maybe it's one. I counsel and work with one person at a time.
So you're a shrink?
Yeah, I'm a head shrink.
Why didn't you say that in the first place?
I did.
She's a housewife, you're a shrink, and he's a crow.
Yeah.
Now I know where I am.
Hey, all right.
You got the lowest end of the deal. All
right.
How do you do it, though? I mean, you run stuff. Do you take them from the city and put them?
Yeah, that's what we do. We'll take them out into the nature. And some people will say, go dig a pit and pour your shit out there because I've had enough of you giving it to me and you're not moving. I'm getting tired of you, all right? And then you get an intuitive sense of who's carrying what and you wait for that point in time where you're gonna go for it with that person. You're going to take them by the scruff and take them through it. So you go do that. Go dig that pit and scream into it.
So somebody in the forest digs a pit?
Yeah.
And screams into the pit?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It must be a riot.
It is, yeah. And some people are hanging upside down.
From trees?
Yeah, with ropes. Because they need to do that, turn their life upside down. Yeah, and some people are up on the top of the mountain. Yeah, and some people were cutting their necks. Sometimes you have to get down to the blood. That's what people are looking for. It's like a birth, yeah? It's traditional, that's old.
What do you like, Charles Manson?
Yeah, positive. Positive.
Positive Charles Manson.
Yeah, because I know that it's only fear that's holding a person down. And I know that I can take them through that place, and I trust myself to be able to do that.
What, so what else do you do besides the cutting of the neck?
So we do, then we do the burial. We'll bury people in the earth, yeah. And the that
and cover them with the earth.
Totally.
That's my biggest. That's yeah.
And you'll be down there, and there'll be no time. I won't say when you're coming out. You just got to wait. You got to go through all that fear like an isolation tank. You don't know when that time's going to come.
Can I come to one of these workshops?
Please.
Why am I doing this?
You're doing it for yourself, Ruby.
Yeah. I know.
For the first time, huh?
But maybe it wasn't such a good idea.
Ruby, it's for you.
Well, actually, not Nick. Not. It's not really for me.
This is your problem. You're doing things for effect. Now you're doing it for real.
Yeah, sure. I don't do things for effect. I told you why I'm doing this. I said it was sort of a funny idea because, you know, I have a television show.
So your life's funny, huh?
No, I thought it would be kind of a snappy end to the show.
This is about you. The process is for you.
I don't know what it's for.
You're getting down inside yourself, Ruby. Like, come on. You've got to dig.
I'm digging. I'm in the dirt. I hate the dirt. I hate... What am I doing here?
That's the problem with you. You hate the dirt of your life. You hate the trash. You don't love the earth. You've got something in the way. Something's in the way of you and the earth.
Oh, now I broke another nail.
Good. Let's have the hand. Let's have you bleeding. You want to bleed for this earth? Let's see you bleed.
No, I really don't.
You talking or are you really getting down in it?
I'm into it. What do you want me to... Where down do you want me to go?
I want you to feel
where you are. What do you want me on all fours? What do you want me to do?
In your life.
Where am I in my life?
Yeah, tell me.
I was doing fine until this event.
You chose to be here.
My back
Where's the calm Ruby? Earth, quiet, still, peaceful, deep.
There is no quiet Ruby.
Well, let's find her.
I've been with her for a long time, and I don't think she's down at the bottom of this pit.
That's where we're going to find you.
Couldn't we just put a couple geraniums in here and call it a day?
It's got nothing to do with you right now.
Really, Nick, honest to God, I'm not kidding now. I really have a pain in my backside. Look, it really hurts right there, and I'm not... It's real. It's coming from my roots. It's coming out of my lower orifice.
That's where
I'm
you
really
wanted to come
pain.
From. Yeah, what's
my,
it about?
My pain in my back, it really hurts.
Tell me about it.
It hurts. My back hurts me.
Well, what's going on in your life? You angry?
Yeah, of course I'm angry.
What are you angry about?
Well, there's thousands of things I'm angry about.
Tell me about it.
This list, there's thousands of people
Get
on
it
the
out.
List.
That's what it's about. Get it out.
Well, my decorators.
Talk about them.
All right, well... They got me some peachy curtains with a floral print, and the wall is maroon. Peachy and maroon don't match. Everybody knows that. They don't match.
So?
Well, so what?
That got you pissed off?
Real pissed off.
And you told them that?
Of course I told them that. I tried to sue them.
So you should feel better?
I don't feel better. They countersued.
So you got more anger?
Yes, I'm furious.
So where's the anger coming from?
I don't know where it's coming from.
Well,
I'm angry.
Well, who else? What else?
Ann Diamond really gets me.
What's wrong with Ann Diamond?
What's wrong with her? Have you seen her show?
No.
All right, she sits on a sofa. The woman sits on a sofa. She never gets up once. Not once. And she makes 80 times more money than I do. Wouldn't
You're
that
jealous.
Leave you?
You're jealous.
Of course I'm jealous.
Pissed off.
Of course I am.
And angry.
I'm very angry.
And it's your anger, your jealousy, your pissed offness.
Yes, that's true. But I don't know anybody else who would do this. Ann Diamond wouldn't do it.
Good for Ann Diamond.
Annika
Maybe she
certainly
hasn't got the
wouldn't
problems
be in
you've
here.
Got, huh?
Ann Diamond doesn't have my problems?
That's likely.
Tell me about it.
You're here.
I know. Annika certainly wouldn't be doing this.
Annika.
Annika would get her jumpsuit filthy. She'd never be doing this.
So that's her problem, huh?
It's totally her problem.
So why do you invest in Annika? What's she got for you?
Nothing. Annika certainly has nothing
she
for
me. She makes you pissed off?
She certainly does.
The seeds of the old Ruby are dying. And the new Ruby's gonna come out from here, under the earth.
I think people really like the old seeds. I think maybe I was really entertaining. I think people like my show. I think I'm gonna be fired. Maybe people are getting concerned now. A special hello to Dawn French. And Diamond, if you're watching, I'm really sorry what I said. I think you're doing a fabulous job.